Hi and welcome back. One of the most fundamental parts of the Google Earth Engine is selecting the images you need and displaying these images, or your own calculated images, on the map. Google has already selected a wide variety of public datasets that you can easily use, and they are listed on their website. You can also browse them in the search bar on the top of your workspace. When you have found the dataset you want to use, select it in the search bar and click Import. Now this image collection has been imported to your script. Image collection is also the variable name that the Earth Engine uses for image collections, so that's very convenient. And now we have created a shortcut so we can easily let the script know what data we want to access. And we can use the name we chose, here L8, as a placeholder for the entire dataset in our script. We could try to print information about this object, but very often you will get an error like this. There are limitations on how much you can ask from the server, and apparently this is one. We can verify how many images there are in a collection with the function size. And when we do that, we find there are almost 800,000 images. So the entire Landsat 8 dataset is clearly too large to work with. We have to filter it somehow. To figure out what function we can use on this object type, we can go to the Docs tab and search for image collection. There are many possible functions, but probably only a few you will use regularly. To quickly filter the data you want to use, there are filter functions. There is a general filter function, a filter bounds, filter date, and filter metadata. The first one is used to filter on specific filters. The Earth Engine has an object called filter, and we can create these and apply them using the first function. The filter bounds let you filter images that fall within a certain region or point. Filter date allows you to select images from a specific date range. And the filter metadata will make it possible to filter on specific characteristics. If you want to know on what properties you can filter, go to the information sheet about your dataset. There you can find the properties of the images and the data type they are in. But let's make this clear with an example. Let's say I want to view all images within a region of North Africa. And not only do I want that, but there cannot be more than 1% cloud cover, and I only want images from 2017. I would start with creating a region of my choice. You could choose to create a polygon from scratch by typing ee.geometry.polygon, followed by the coordinates of your region, but you can also simply draw one on the map. And once this is drawn, we have created a new object. I will call this region. Now let's look back at the filter bounds function. As the docs tell us, we could have also created a filter object, the filter.bounds, and then use that created filter in the filter function. But since it is such a common operation, it has its own function. The only other argument that is required is a geometry. This could have also been a point or a line, but in this example we are looking for a region. Okay, let's apply this. If you have typed the function correctly, it should mark purple. And let's see how many images there remain in the collection. For that, we can use the function size again. And we see there are still over 3000 images in this collection. So let's continue with the example. We also wanted images with less than 1% cloud cover. For that, we will use the filter metadata function. This function seems to require a name, that is the name of the property you want to filter, an operator, which means less than, equal to, and so on, and finally a number. And again, we have reduced our amount of images significantly, but let's go a little further and select only images from the year 2017. The function requires a start date and an end date. These dates can be written in different ways, either as a date object, a string, or an integer, but I'll use the string for simplicity. And finally, we have reduced our collection to well over 200 images. It is still a lot, but much more manageable compared to the initial 800,000. We did not have to create variables for each individual step as we did here. We could have also stacked the filters on top of each other, like this, and make it a little more readable, like so. We could then show the entire collection on the map, but there will probably be a lot of overlaying pictures from different times of the year. So what I'll do is take the median of this collection and print the image that the median function returns. The median function is easy to use and requires no additional arguments. And when we add this to the map, we get this result. You can adjust the represented layers and coloring here. And you can also save it so you won't have to adjust this every time. When you want to reuse earlier parameters, you can add them to your map.addLayer function. And you can also give your layer a name. And that's it. In 6 lines of code, we have been able to filter an immense dataset and display the result. If you have any questions about this, leave it in the comments so I can try to help, and I will see you in the next video.